where somebody had died, got one of these, and these would be found in homes right across Ireland, north and south. I'll just go on then. The only difference being is that unionist homes that would probably be high up on the wall or on a, so where people could see them with pride, but in nationalist homes, Republican homes, they would probably be up in the roof space or in a drawer. However, because they didn't want their neighbours and all to know that they served in the British forces. However, those attitudes are now changing, and there's a greater acknowledgement and recognition of Irish men north and south, and that they all have to be honoured, they all have to be acknowledged, and tribute given to them all, whether it be nationalist, unionist, republican or whatever, they all have to be acknowledged. Sit on, Frankie, and then we'll stop up here on the left. In 1969, this area didn't look like this. This was there was no wall, and it was all small terraced housing. Outside toilets, there was no inside toilets, no inside bathrooms, all outside toilets. And Roman Catholics and Protestants, see where people are standing, just about there, stop about there. They all lived in the same type of houses. They all worked in the same factories in the area. But in August 1969, it's a long story, but very briefly, a sectarian strife started to develop. Protestants believed that organizations like the civil rights movement was being used to undermine the state of Northern Ireland. A lot of the Protestants seen Roman Catholics, because of their support in elections and voting for Sinn Féin, which is a political wing of the IRA, they then seen the Roman Catholic population as being supportive of the IRA. So in August 1969, Protestants, Unionists attacked Roman Catholic homes on this side here, your left hand side where the wall is, the other side. They attacked Bombay Street. It was a horrific time, I remember it well. And the Roman Catholic people were terrified. The Roman Catholic authorities appealed for the British Army to come in to restore peace. The British Army came in, fixed bayonets, barbed wire, and the restored peace. The Roman Catholic people were so delighted that they came out and gave the British Army sandwiches, coffee, tea, you know. But that relationship with the British Army was not the last.